has condemned the destruction of property and burning of more than 20 schools in Vuwani, Limpopo province. Addressing the media in parliament during a post-cabinet briefing, Defence Minister Nosiviwe Mapisa Nqakula said such behaviour undermined the right of children to education. But for an update on Vuwani, we're now joined by our reporter Mike Maringa, who's on the ground there tracking that story. Good afternoon, Mike. Thank you for your time on the SABC News Desk. A new calm settling over Vuwani today.
Good afternoon, Keshni. Yes, it's indeed calm is settling here at Vuwani. We have seen ministers and MEC who have been hard at work, working around the clock to ensure that there is stability here at Vuwani and other areas. But I'm coming to you live from Chikonelo, where the interministerial team is meeting with the Chikonelo community, the chief and his subjects. Look, an issue of social cohesion is topping the charts here. We've got few ministers that are here, and with me here is the Minister of Communication, Mefaith Muthambi, just to give us a brief of what is happening at that meeting. Minister, welcome to SABC. What's happening at the meeting?
Yes, there's engagement, and I'm loving it that now the communities are dialoguing. The communities here believe in talking. They are saying since these things happened, that it's business as usual. People are going to school, people are going to work. It has even happened during the Malamlele riots. They took responsibility and got their properties such that none of the state properties, including social buildings, were ever burned in this area. That's the responsibility that they've taken upon themselves to say they are responsible citizens. And then what they are raising, what is very critical that needs urgent attention, is the issue of social cohesion. To say, you know, they are neighboring the other part called Basani, Chikonel, is just, they are staying together in faith to say that what is critical for them is integrity and social cohesion, of which they need to see together as citizens so that they relate together. But otherwise, here everything is going on well, in the sense that everything is smooth. They are raising the critical element, their social cohesion, and as government, it's a challenge for us as ministry responsible for that aspect, that we need to go back to the drawing board and make sure that there's social cohesion in this area.
Minister, you seem to have managed to diffuse the tension. I mean, hearing from the hall, it looks like these people are ready to live together. They are ready to attend to each other, to attend to the same schools and all that. As government, how did you manage to win that battle that was looming, to say that there's tribalism? That seems to have faded out. Before you leave, Minister, I see you're on your way out.
You've heard it from the traditional leadership himself, saying that since 1994, they've made sure that they integrate. Like, these are vendor schools where in Shangan is also taught. They also employed Shangan teachers to make sure that they are in, it's a community, it's an effort on their part that they've done as a community. Hence, you can even say, they're saying now, we won't touch any building. We believe in engagement. We are so excited that you as government have come to engage with us. Hence, we're engaging with you on all this matter to say, this is the way we feel we need to do. Then that brings me to our two-way communication that we always say, to say as government, our people want contact with their public representative, and this is exactly that we are seeing happening here.
That was Minister of Communication Faith Muthambi outlining what is happening at that meeting. Understand the meeting just concluded, but this is not the last for the day. From here, they are going to a village called Dabani. They are still going to meet with a community and the community leaders just to advance their message to say there must be calm. We have seen there is calm here, and probably where we're going, it will be the same situation. Krishni is back to you at the studio.
Mike Maringa on the ground there from Vuwani in Limpopo province. Of course, social cohesion, dialogue and improved consultation really helping to restore calm and order in Vuwani today. Communities, they're really feeling that they are being engaged and listened to by those in the corridors of power. We'll bring you regular updates on Vuwani throughout the course of the afternoon, so keep it locked on to the SABC News channel.